Assalamu alaikum, Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Myself is MD Farooq Hossain, Senior Assistant Teacher of Islamabad Collegiate School, Khulna. Dear student, you know, due to COVID-19, manual class has been suspended, but online class is going on. I think it will help you to carry on your study. So, dear student, let's go to start. Dear student, today I have prepared my lecture for class 10 on Islam and Moral Education on chapter 1. The subject matter of this chapter is Aqeedah and Moral Life. Today I shall discuss the lesson 13 and 14. Lesson 13, Aqeedah. Akhirat is an Arabic word. It means life after death. The life after death is called Akhirat. Akhirat is an unending life. It has a beginning but no ending. It is man's eternal abode. Man will be asked to account for his early deeds in Akhirat. Now, importance of Akhirat. To believe in Akhirat is indispensable because without belief in it, it is impossible to become a mu'min. Allah the Most High says, and they hold firm belief in Akhirat. Belief in Akhirat restrains man from sin and inspires him to virtuous deeds. Belief in Akhirat also renders man's life responsible, clean and pure. Lesson 14. Some essence of life in Akhirat. Akhirat is the next life. The life after death is termed as Akhirat. That life is everlasting and unending. That life has no end. Akhirat or the next life has a good number of essence. We shall briefly know about the different levels or phases of Akhirat now. Essence of Akhirat. Number 1, death. Number 2, grave, that means kabur. Number 3, doomsday, that means kiamat. Number 4, grand assembly, that means hashur. Number 5, the balance, that means mizan. Number 6, the biris, that means sirat. Number 7, intercession, that means shafaat. Number 8, heaven, that means jannat. And number 9, hell, that means jahannam. Number 1, death. Death is the gate of next life. Akhirat starts with death. No living creature will escape death. Allah says, every living being must experience the taste of death. A virtuous man embraces death with Allah's mercy. On the other hand, the death of a sinner is very painful. Number 2, grave, that means kabur. The Arabic synonym of the word grave is qabr or barzakh. The time from death till resurrection is called grave. The angel named Munkar and Nakir will ask 3 questions to everyone in the grave. Those who have lived their life according to Islam will be able to give correct answers of the questions. But those who have not followed Islam will not be able to give the correct answers of the questions. So, we should follow the Islam and lead our life according to the Sharia. The questions in the grave are given below. Question number 1, Marabbuka, who is your Lord? The answer of this question is Rabbi Allah. That means Allah is our Lord. Question number 2, Oma Dinuka, what is your faith or what is your Deen? Answer of the question, Deen il Islam. That means the name of our religion is Islam. Question number 3, Oma Nabiuka, who is your prophet? Or pointing to the messenger will be asked, Oman Hadar Rajul, who is this man? Answer of this question, this man is Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Number three, the doomsday, that means Qiyamah. Qiyamah is an Arabic word. It has two meanings. There, Qiyamah means doomsday or absolute destruction. Number two, Qiyamah means to stand up before Allah for judgment. There was a time when nothing existed. The whole universe with its components was not existence. Allah has created everything in His infinite power. Again, a time will come when He will destroy the entire universe and all its parts. This is called Qiyamah. Allah will revive all creatures after a long time for judgment, when, at the command of Allah, Israfil alayhi salam will again blow his trumpet. Then everyone have to stand up before Allah to account for his activities. This is also called Qiyamah. Hashr. Hashr is an Arabic word. It means grand assembly. All will assemble in the field of Hashr. This field is vast and well ordered. All men from first to the last on will assemble in this field. This grand assembly of man is called Hashr. The day of Hashr is the day of accounts and accountability. Man will be given his Amal Nama in the field of Hashr. The field of Hashr is a place of horrible hardship. On that day, the sun will be very close above the head. Man will be sweating under intense heat. Seven classes of men will be under the arrows of Allah. Only the water of the pond of Kawthar will be offered for the virtuous by Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now mizan, the balance. Mizan means an instrument or balance for measurement. The balance that Allah the Most High will install in the field of Hashr for measuring the deeds of man is called the mizan. Allah the Most High says, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. وَنَضَاءُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ, meaning, and on the day of resurrection, we shall install the mizan of justice. Surah Al-Anbiya, Ayat 47. Those who will find the right hand of balance heavier will enter into the paradise. And those who will find the left hand of the balance heavier will enter into the hell. Now Sirat, the bridge. The word Sirat literally means path, way, bridge, method, it is. In the terminology of Islam, in Sharia, Sirat means a dark bridge installed over the head. A virtuous servant of Allah will enter the paradise after crossing this bridge. In the next life, all men will have to pass over this bridge. In the Holy Quran, Allah the Most High says about Sirat, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and everyone of you will have to pass over it. It is an inevitable decision of your Lord. Surah Maryam, Ayat 71. The Holy Prophet says, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, يُوضَعُ الْصِرَاطُ بَيْنَ زُهْرَ جَهَنَّمُ, meaning the bridge will be placed over the hell. Musnadi Ahmad. The Sirat is a dark bridge. A mu'min or virtuous man will find light there. But those who are not mu'min and those who are sinners will not find light arranged for them. So he who has firm faith and done good deeds, the Sirat will be more lighted for him. He will pass the bridge easily in the light of Iman. On the contrary, those who are not mu'min and are sinners, Allah will order them to go to hell. The Sirat is a very frightful place for the inmates of hell. For them, the Sirat will be narrower than a string of hair and sharper than a sword. Under such conditions, they will not be able to cross the bridge by any means. Rather, they will fall into the hell in a very pitiable manner. Shafaat, intercession. Shafaat means to recommend, to request, etc. In the terminology of the Islamic Shariat, the recommendation of the prophets and messengers and other favorite servants of Allah for the welfare and forgiveness from Allah is called Shafaat. On the day of Qiyamah, the messengers and prophets and the virtuous servants of Allah will make recommendation to Him. Allah the Most High will accept these recommendations and bless many men with paradise. However, the highest power of recommendation will be held by our beloved Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He himself has said, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. U'titu ash-shafa'ah. That means, I have been granted the right to make recommendation. Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. Now, Jannat. Jannat is an Arabic word. It means park, garden, etc. The most comfortable place which has been prepared for the virtuous is called Jannat. Jannat is the abode of eternal happiness. The happiness of Jannat are unbounded. Those who will follow the Islamic Shariat completely will enter into the Jannat. Allah has kept ready 8 heavens for the virtuous. There, number 1, Jannatul Firdaus. Number 2, Darul Makam. Number 3, Darul Arar. Number 4, Darul Salam. Number 5, Jannatul Mawa. Number 6, Jannatul Ad. Number 7, Darul Na'im. And number 8, Darul Khuld. And the last point about Jahannam. Jahannam is an Arabic word. It means fire, the extreme punishable place which has been prepared for the sinner. Is called Jahannam. It is the place of eternal punishment. It is the habitat of snakes and scorpions. The food there is big thorny cactus. The drink for the dwellers of Jahannam will be blood and pus. Allah has kept ready 7 hell for the sinners. There, number 1, Jahannam. Number 2, Habiya. Number 3, Jahim. Number 4, Saqar. Number 5, Sa'id. Number 6, Hutama. And number 7, Laza. Dear student, some questions have been given below for your practice. You will try to solve the answer of the question by yourselves. Question number 1, what is Akhirat? Question number 2, what is grave? Question number 3, what is Qiyamat? Question number 4, what is Sirat? Question number 5, what is Jannat? Question number 6, what is Jahannam? Question number 7, write the questions with answer in the grave. Question number 8, write the stress of Akhirat. Question number 9, who will go to Jannat? And question number 10, who will go to Jahannam? Dear student, no more now. More when we shall meet next. I shall try to come back next week, inshallah.